Hi, in this video, I'll demo the creation of a new data access API. Once you're onboarded and logged into the API platform management console, click on the partner code dropdown and navigate to your API dashboard. Click on new to create your new data access API. You can create your new API by just configuring your API details and attributes from this user experience. Enter the API name. This is the name of your new API, which would also be part of the REST endpoint URL generated by the platform. You can choose your API version and the category. Category is nothing but a logical grouping of your APIs that can improve searchability. This is an autocomplete select box, which will be pre-populated with the existing categories created by you. You can choose to add a new category as well. Select the database you wish to use. You can choose to use default dedicated database offered by the platform or configure your own database. In this version, platform only supports MongoDB. To configure your existing database connection, you need to navigate to My Account, click on Databases tab and configure the database by providing all required details. Once you create this entry, this should show up in this drop-down list. You can choose to restrict access to your API by configuring the access type private. If you select private API, access is restricted to the list of whitelisted IPs as configured in your account. You can edit this list by navigating to My Account and clicking on the IP whitelist tab. There, you can provide a comma separated list of IPs, which would be the IPs for which the APIs would be provided access to. If no access specifier is selected, by default, the APIs are created with public access. You can choose your API display name and description and proceed with the attribute definition. I have now entered a sample attribute definition with the required data type, the type of the key. Basically, if it's a primary, unique, or a simple field by itself. You can also choose required in case you would like to make the attribute not null or non-empty, which is a mandatory field. You can also choose the storage policy to be encrypted and the access policy to be encrypted, decrypted, or masked. Here, I've selected the attribute password to be masked and encrypted as the storage policy. API definition can be done through the UI console, which is this definition tab by itself, or providing a valid JSON, or you can even create an API from an existing API as well. Just provide the API link, choose if you would like to import the data, and make sure to provide the headers required to authorize this API access. You can also choose to create your API from a database by selecting the database name, the target database, and the list of tables. You can choose to use referential keys, also import the data as well. Let's go back to the definition and create our data access API. Once you click on Create API, the database is configured and default REST data access API endpoints are generated. Since I have selected public, these are readily available for use to perform CRUD operations. You can now see that your data access APIs are created and the API endpoints are now available for you to use.